Okay, sir, we can start. We have got around 100 participants.
Yes, we may.
So before you begin, I'd like to good morning, my dear students, teachers, and friends. It's morning in India, so I wish all of you a very good morning. And let me, in the beginning of this wonderful session, introduce our guest speaker today. It's my privilege to introduce our honorable guest speaker today, Mr. Avinash Deshmukh, who is an engineer by qualification. Good morning, sir. An internationally certified career coach, certified by the National Career Development Alliance, USA. He is the innovator of unique programs like Har Ghar Mein Genius, which we all want, and BoldNet for youngsters. Mr. Avinash has helped thousands of youngsters to shape and enhance their career through his intelligent and innovative coaching and advanced training and counseling. It's indeed a great blessing and opportunity for all of us, especially our students, to be able to listen to a very capable and extremely gifted guide like you, Mr. Avinash Deshmukh. So at the beginning of this meeting, I would like to welcome you, sir, and thank you for giving us your time to guide our students. I would have asked all my students to give you a big round of applause, but since it is a Zoom meeting, I would like to again say thank you very much, and we are eagerly awaiting to listen to your guidance.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, and good morning to everybody.
Good morning. Good
all
morning,
the students, all the parents, all the teaching staff, and of course,
good morning, sir.
Father Simon D'Souza, sir. Good morning, everybody. And I hope we all are having a fantastic, fabulous morning.
Yeah, yes.
I would request all of you to put your videos on, because talking to blank screen is not really good.
Yeah.
And I'm sure teachers will agree with me, right, teachers?
Yes, 100%.
Because for last almost more than a year, teachers have been struggling with this new medium of teaching, and I can fully relate with them how they feel when the students are not opening up their videos. So many times it feels whether are we talking to blank walls or what. So friends, it would be great, because we are going to keep this interactive session, and the more you interact, the more you learn. That's the simple process. I've been involved into brain development processes, and simple fundamental brain development process is that most of your senses should be involved in learning. The more all the five senses are involved in learning, the more will be your learning. It's as simple as that, and I'm sure all the teachers will agree with me. So I would request all of you to be interactive, because I am going to ask you to answer some questions. I am going to ask you to respond. So be ready, students, be ready with your keyboard, because yes, many times you are going to respond and you have to respond. So friends, thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to be part of this noble initiative by the school, because yes, this is very, very necessary that schools should be having the career guidance process in place. And I'm really happy that Vidya Bhavan School has taken this initiative for all of you. And I'm sure this initiative will go much beyond just a session. It will actually go in helping out the students to identify their career, to develop their career. I suppose all the students present in this webinar today are from 11th and 12th standard?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Wonderful. Wonderful. So I'm sure a part of your journey has already begun. You have already chosen certain path. Some of you might be absolutely clear about what they want to do in coming 5-6 years, at least, if not life. But some of you still might be thinking, ki chalo karke dekhte hain. Let's see how do I get my scores in my JEE, or how do I get my scores in my NEET, or how do I get my scores in my NATA exam, or some my design exam. So I'm sure some of you still might be wondering, kya karna hai malum nahi, papa ne bol diya isliye science ko ja rahi hu, ya mummy ne insist kiya isliye main arts liya hu, ya maybe I don't know, I want to do something but I'm not sure. Is this the kind of mindset more or less with everybody? go and type yes in the chat room if you agree with me that this is the mindset, more or less. Maybe somebody might have some slightly different mindset, but is it right if I, whatever I'm saying, either of these mindsets are there? Okay, okay, yes, 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 fantastic. I love your responses. Vedang, yes, he says yes. Then Alicia says yes. Mr. Okay, I think some of you have not named you, so reading out your mobile number, the model numbers would be really funny. But yes, yes. So these are some of the responses which you guys are having, and I love your responses. Thank you for being proactively supportive. So friends, today I'm not really going to talk a lot about various different career options, because that is one fundamental mistake which we all have been making. But I'm going to take you through a small process. How do you identify your right career? And of course, I'm going to talk about certain careers. So I have a small PPT to be shared, although it might continue till the entire session. So I take the liberty of calling it small. Okay, so can we people have ourselves muted so that we don't disturb others? Okay, so are you guys ready for a fantastic journey for next 40-45 minutes? Let me have some responses. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Wow, fantastic, fantastic. Thank you so much. I love this statement of Stephen Covey. Stephen says, I am not a product of my circumstances. I am a product of my decisions. How many of you agree with this? Type yes if you agree with this statement. Type yes you would like to, if you would like to follow this statement in your life. You are a product of your decisions and you are not a product of your circumstances. You would like to take the complete responsibility of your life, irrespective of where you stand, irrespective of what you face. Type yes if you agree with this statement. Type yes if you are ready to take charge in your life. Type yes if you feel, whatever happens in my life, I am responsible for it. Because your career will be absolutely and only your responsibility and nothing, nobody else's responsibility. Well, lovely, lovely. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. So friends, let's come to some fundamental things about career decision. Is career just a profession or is it a life? Is this decision which can be taken overnight? Is this decision which can be taken by consulting anybody and everybody? All those uncles and aunties and friends and mamas and chachas, those who have gone, they have their own life to lead, they have their own challenges to face, and they have their own karma to be faced. Or is it a scientific process? Or is it simply your thought, my interest, mujhe jo achha lag raha hai wahi karunga, ya mujhe jo achha lag raha hai wahi karungi? Or is it some external force? What do you feel? Is your career only a profession or it is your life? Please go ahead and chat, type in the chat room. Is it your life or is it just your profession? Let me understand what you people feel about it. Okay, Shruti says life, Vedang says life, Jessica says life, Alicia says life. Okay, Keen says, okay, maybe professional, she's not sure. Okay, most of you are saying life, life, life. Okay, Shivani says life, Catherine says life. Okay, Ambarish says ikigai, that's good. Okay, Manav says life. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. So most of you feel it is not just about a profession. It's not about just 10 to 5 job. It's not about just a particular business as well. It is actually your life. You are going to lead a life through your profession. Absolutely right. Absolutely right. Okay. I think I went ahead. Okay. So let me ask you one simple question. Oh, should your degree decide your career or should your dream decide your degree? How many of you people feel that degree should decide your career should type degree, and those who feel that your dream should decide your degree should type dream? Let me see how many of you are. Okay, dream. Okay, Jayant, dream. Noel, dream. Okay, dream. Everybody's feeling dream. Is it so? Wow, yes. I love your energy. I love your responses. That's the way to go about anything in life. Fantastic. Ajinkya also says dream. Elvina says dream. Fantastic. Okay, both and its combination. Okay, interesting. Okay, fantastic. So most of you are feeling that your dream should decide your degree. Degree is part of your journey. Degree should not decide your journey. Wonderful. Thank you so much. So my dear friends, I'm sure if you agree with the earlier statement, you will agree that your career is not just a career. You are on a mission. You are on a mission, whatever it might be. How many of you agree? Students, I would want you to respond on this. How many of you say that you are on a mission when you think of a career? Type mission in the chat room. Wow. Fantastic. Superb. I'm thankful that I'm able to connect with you. So let's see how does it actually go ahead. Actually, the career, as far as this decision is concerned, and particularly when you are in standard 11 and 12, this is the most crucial decision of your life. And globalization and technology has opened up new plethora of career options and challenges to the youth. And you all know, I'm sure, that in India, we are the world's largest youngest population. And it is a fantastic pride for all of us. We have been listening to these words rather for more than a few years now. We are the world's youngest population, and we have the largest population in the world, which is youngest in the world. So we are actually standing on a huge opportunity which the world is looking forward to give it to us. My simple question is, are you equipped enough and right to encash the opportunity the world is offering? Think yourself, are you really equipped enough? Let's look at some reality facts. I am sure some of these facts might be disappointing, but these are facts and we have to face it. We all have gone through this process of doing some or the other career journey, and particularly the parents. I hope the parents are also here on the webinar today. And we have gone through the tremendous grind of becoming an engineer or becoming a doctor or becoming an MBA or taking up any other profession and completing the educational journey for that. And what has been the result? 96% of the candidates across all sectors have been found unemployable, according to the third CII National Conference on Skill Development. 96% candidates found unemployable. This is a this is a huge number, and this is highly disappointing number as well. Let me tell you another fact. USA produces 1 lakh engineers per year for a $16 trillion economy. Whereas in India, we produce 15 lakh engineers for a $2 trillion economy. Now, how does that comparison go? आजकल तो हमारे यहाँ पे ऐसा होने लगा है, ऐसे लोग बोलने लगे कि इंजीनियरिंग हैज बिकम ए बेसिक ग्रेजुएशन जस्ट द वे इट वॉज बी ए बीकॉम और बी एस सी फ्यू ईयर्स अगो. इंजीनियरिंग इज द बेसिक ग्रेजुएशन. यू वॉन्ट टू डू एनीथिंग इन लाइफ, फर्स्ट डू इंजीनियरिंग. This is the kind of thing has happened, and that's why we have so many engineering colleges across the country. In fact, every town, every small town is having engineering colleges. Of course, in last few years, many of those engineering colleges have been shut down. Many of the engineering colleges are not getting enough admissions. That is also a fact nowadays. And NASSCOM recent survey states that only 1 in 5 engineers are employable. Now, let me just quickly explain you employable, because some of the students might not really relate with this term. Employability is when you go for an interview, when the person assesses you, checks on you, and he finds that, no, you are not ready for the job. you have not developed yourself in the schooling and college years so that I could employ you for whatever I have as requirement. Students have fancy resumes. Students have fancy things to be mentioned in the resumes, but they practically are not ready to get employed. And that's why a lot of unemployment is around. And on the other side, all the organizations are facing this problem of having right kind of people. So they are running on under recruitment or manpower crunch. And on the other side, youngsters are not finding jobs. That's simply because youngsters are not skilled enough to take up the jobs which the industry is offering right now. There is a wide gap between what is available and what is required. I am sure none of you would like to land up into such situation wherein you complete your 5, 6, 7 years of grind in the educational sector. And if you want to do a job, the companies, the organizations are not ready to accept you. I am sure none of you would like to land in such kind of situation. And am I right? Type yes in the chat room if you agree with my statement that you will not like to land up in such kind of situation 5, 6, 7 years down the line. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. I'm sure this is this requires no brainer, but yes, this is important. The point which I wanted to emphasize was that being employable is more important. Now, that does not mean only for job. Being employable even for starting a business is also equally important. You should be in a position to start your business. Having an idea is not enough. And we will sometimes later talk a lot about it. But being employable means either if you want to get into a job or you want to get into your own profession, your own business, being employable is very, very important. Your simple degree is not going to help you. That's the point which I wanted to drive across. Let's look at some of the other facts also. 56.49% of students passed NEET 2019 out of 7.97 lakh students who appeared for the exam. Almost 1 lakh students remained absent. So they were preparing for NEET almost for 2 years. Some might have prepared for more than 2 years. And out of those students, 1 lakh students didn't even appear for the exam. And I wonder what happened to those 44% who failed the exam. They must be having an aspiration to get into the health sector. They must be having an aspiration to get into medical sector, but they could not pass the qualifying examination, and hence they might have changed their dream. Now look at the unfortunate part of life. They must have pursued this for some time and with a lot of passion, possibly. And when they failed, they are forced to change the field now. Similarly, about 9 lakh students compete for the 12,000 IIT seats. Can you imagine? Can you look at this competition? I know engineering mein aajkal wo situation nahi hai. Every person who gets qualified in the JEE will get some or the other engineering college in the country. That's the situation. But again, most of you don't prefer any college. You want certain colleges. And that's the reason most of the students who qualify in JEE, when they don't get their expected colleges, they actually drop engineering dream. They go to some other profession. They go to some other education. Now, that's again unfortunate part. And out of 33,000 students who compete, there are only 906 architectural seats available in India. And for 100 seats of NID, 5,000 students compete. Now, this is the slightly it might feel scary, but yes, this is a situation right now in India. My dear friends, when majority of the students who compete and emerge winners actually don't get employed. Look at my first slide. 96% of the candidates across. Now, this percentage might be varying for engineering and medicine or any other chartered accountancy or any other course. So individual category percentage will vary. But on an average, 96% of the candidates are not employable in spite of after going through so much of grind in the college and before college. Can you imagine what can be the plight of the students who don't qualify at all? Now, let me tell you, we all have gone through this. All the parents will agree with me. And possibly this is one of the reasons that majority of us are leading a life which we are not made for. And that is one of the reasons that we are possibly unhappy. How many of you feel that you would like to not have such kind of situation and would like to lead a happy life? Type happy in the chat room. You don't want to get into this kind of situation wherein you are forced to lead a life which is not full of happiness, which does not make you smile. Type happy if you agree with this. Type happy if you want to lead a happy life. Let me tell you one small story. How many of you are ready for a story? You can either give me a raise of hands or you can say yes, yes, a small story. Would you like to listen to a small story?
Yes.
Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. Story थोड़ा हिंदी में बताऊंगा क्योंकि हिंदी में स्टोरी बताने का जो मजा आता है वो शायद इंग्लिश में मुझे नहीं आता है. सो एक गांव होता है, उस गांव में यू नो यूजुअली विलेज गांव में कुत्ते होते हैं, बहुत सारे स्ट्रे डॉग्स होते हैं, या भले वो स्ट्रे डॉग्स ना हो, किसी ना किसी फैमिली के हो, लेकिन दिन भर गांव में घूमते रहते हैं, इधर उधर लेटे रहते हैं. सो एक गांव के बाहर बहुत सारे कुत्ते ऐसे छाव में लेटे रहते हैं. दोपहर का समय है, बहुत सारे कुत्ते लेटे हुए हैं, एंड वन डॉग, एक कुत्ता भागने लगता है, जोर से भागने लगता है, एंड वो गांव से बाहर निकलता है और रोड से भागता है. उसको भागते हुए देख के सारे कुत्ते उसके पीछे भागने लगते हैं. यू नो डॉग्स, हाउ डॉग्स आर, राइट? द मोमेंट दे सी समबडी इज मूविंग, इफ योर बाइक और योर कार इज मूविंग, दे वुड लाइक टू चेज इट. सो ये कुत्ते उसके पीछे भागने लगते, भागते भागते भागते, फिर टॉमी भागने लगा है, फिर जैकी भागने लगा है, मोती भागने लगा है, सब भागने लगते हैं. एंड ये हमारा एक जो लीडर कुत्ता होता है वो सबसे आगे भाग रहा है, उसके पीछे सब भाग रहे. काफी देर भाग रहे, 20 मिनट हो गए, 25 मिनट हो गए, दे आर जस्ट रनिंग. फिर भी थोड़ी देर बाद जो पीछे लोग होते हैं उनसे जुड़ते जाते हैं, काफी सारे तकरीबन 40-50 कुत्ते उसके पीछे भाग रहे हैं. फिर जो लास्ट में कुत्ता होता है वो पूछता है, यार हम लोग क्यों भाग रहे हैं? तो बाजू वाला कुत्ता बोलता है, पता नहीं यार, ये सामने वाला भाग रहा है इसलिए मैं भाग रहा हूँ. बोलते चलो उसको पूछते हैं. फिर उसको पूछते हैं तो बोलते यार पता नहीं, मुझे नहीं मालूम, वो सामने वाला कुत्ता भाग रहा था इसलिए मैं भाग रहा था. अरे यार ऐसे कैसे? फिर वो और आगे जाके पूछते हैं तो वो भी बोलता है, यार आई डोंट नो, ये सामने कुत्ता भाग रहा था, जाके भाग रहा था इसलिए मैं भाग रहा हूँ. ऐसा पूछते 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 ऑलमोस्ट पूरा लॉट खत्म हो जाता है, तभी किसी को मालूम नहीं है कि वो क्यों भाग रहे हैं. एंड हमारा जो लीडर कुत्ता था जो सबसे पहले भाग रहा था, वो भागे जा रहा है, वो किसी को देख नहीं रहा है पीछे मेरे कौन आ रहा है कौन नहीं आ रहा है. तो इसमें से ये जो पीछे 50-100 कुत्ते भाग रहे थे, उसमें से कुछ कुत्ते थक जाते हैं, बोलते छोड़ ना यार, बेकार में क्यों भागने का, क्यों भाग रहे हैं हम लोग, मालूम नहीं, बस भागे जा रहे, 2, 4, 5 किलोमीटर, 10 किलोमीटर भाग रहे हैं, और फिर थक जाते हैं, हट जाते हैं. धीरे 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 कुछ कुत्ते रुक जाते हैं, भागना बंद कर देते हैं, और फिर भी हमारा लीडर कुत्ता भाग रहा है. एंड ही रीचेस वन स्पॉट इन द जंगल. वो जंगल में उस स्पॉट पे पहुंचता है एंड ही स्टार्ट्स टू यू नो डिग आउट द ग्राउंड. जमीन को कुरेदता है और उसमें से वो मुंह में पकड़ के कुछ बाहर निकालता है. एंड दैट टाइम देर वेर 3 or 4 अदर डॉग्स हु मैनेज टू चेज हिम समहाउ. जब बाकी सारे रुक गए थे, वो 4-5 कुत्ते उसके साथ भागे जा रहे थे, और वो देखते हैं थोड़ी दूरी से कि इस एक कुत्ते को उसका रैबिट मिल गया. नाउ द मॉरल ऑफ द स्टोरी इज, एक कुत्ते को रैबिट का टारगेट था, उसको रैबिट दिखा था, उसने रैबिट के लिए भागना चालू किया और उसने रैबिट अचीव कर लिया. लेकिन व्हाट हैपेंड टू अदर्स? वो क्यों भाग रहे थे? हमारे देश में बहुत सारी स्टोरी हम सबकी ऐसी है, भागे जा रहे, लाखों बच्चे नीट में बैठ रहे, लाखों बच्चे इंजीनियरिंग में जा रहे हैं, मालूम नहीं है उनका रैबिट वहां पे है या नहीं. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू एग्री विद दिस? टाइप एग्री इन द चैट रूम इफ यू एग्री विद माई स्टेटमेंट. We keep on running. In fact, parents will relate with me a lot on this because they have actually experienced this life. Yes. Most of you are agreeing with this. This is how it is happening. Wonderful. Thank you so much. So let's move on that we are not going to actually lead a life which doesn't have any purpose. We are not going to lead a life wherein हम हमारा रैबिट हमको मालूम ही नहीं है. सो माय डियर फ्रेंड, देन व्हाट शुड वी डू? लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड. मैं तो आपको एक बहुत बहुत बेसिक लेवल का एक दो तीन चीजें बताने वाला हूं अभी नेक्स्ट तीन चार स्लाइड्स में, एंड देन उसके बाद वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक मोर डिटेल अबाउट सम अदर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ मेकिंग दिस करियर. सो व्हाट एक्चुअली मेक्स ए सक्सेसफुल करियर? सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड सम बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट्स विद सम सिंपल फंडामेंटल एग्जाम्पल्स. लेट मी टेल यू, quite a few of you might be aiming for becoming a designer simply because you like to draw. And now there is a misconception in the market that if you like drawing, only then you should go for design, whereas this is not the case. Let me tell you, to become a successful designer, apart from your designing degree, and sometimes it may also not be required, if you are good enough, if people start recognizing your work, you know, globally, so many technocrats are college dropouts. Successful technocrats are college dropouts, including Bill Gates, including Mark Zuckerberg, and there are so many. But we have been taught that padhai karni hai, degree leni hai, uske baad successful designer ban jayega. The fact is, designer banne ke liye aapke andar, you should have certain basic intelligences or potential, and you should have developed certain skills in you. And to become a successful designer, I'm not saying to qualify for the design entrance examination. No, I'm not talking about your qualification for the exam. I'm talking for success in career. Now, intelligences might be visual and spatial intelligence, interpersonal and spatial intelligence, fine motor skills and logical intelligence, and visual and spatial again. Yeah, let's repeat it. And apart from these basic intelligence, so basically you need a good visual and spatial intelligence. You need good fine motor and logical analytical skills or logical analytical intelligence. And apart from that, you need creativity, imagination. Yes, being good with drawing definitely will help you. It will be definitely a good advantage, but you also need people skills as well. And there are many other things. These are some of the basic things required for a design career. Only then you can think of feel that you can become successful in a career of design. Similarly, if you go for engineering, I'm sure many of you aspire for becoming an engineer. Although yes, engineering is one of the evergreen career, no doubt. But are you actually an engineer? I'm not talking by degree, by your personality design, by your potential, by your talent. Look at these intelligences. An engineer has to be good at logical and analytical skills. Engineer also has to be good at spatial intelligence. Engineer also has to be good at naturalistic intelligence. And of course, he needs good intrapersonal and interpersonal intelligences also. Apart from that, he has to have functional skills. He has to have self-motivation. He should be good at people, and he should be good at communication. Of course, certain knowledge of financial aspects will also definitely help him. So these are some of the, I'm giving you random examples, but let me tell you, just getting into IIT is not going to make you good engineer. There are quite a few friends of mine who have passed out from IIT, and then they have gone to management, that is IIM. And then they have completed their UPSC qualification, and right now they are serving as collectors or, you know, forest officers or foreign officers. So where is the connection with engineering, management? Of course, management and UPSC ka connection hai, lekin engineering ka aur uska kya connection hai? So becoming a successful engineer is not about just having a degree from any of the best engineering institute in India. It is all about, do you have the engineer in you? If you want to become engineer, similarly for medicine, these are the skills required for becoming a good doctor. One more skill, one more intelligence which is required, that is naturalistic intelligence, a good sense of observation, a good sense of differentiation. Now, this is something which is never taught in any college or school. What is your sense of differentiation? What is in your sense of observation? This is something you know on your own, and you can develop it on your own. But if you don't have these skills, you will find it difficult in spite of the fact that you might have qualified the entrance exam. Because India mein entrance exam qualify karna alag baat hai, aur successful career karna alag baat hai. there are many doctors who end up becoming builders, and you know there are some doctors who have also become actors, and they have become successful actors. But unfortunately, in the process, because they scored a good score in their entrance examination, they blocked one medical seat which could have gone to a prospective doctor who would have loved to become only doctor. He was a doctor, but he could not qualify in the entrance exam, and that's why he could not become a doctor. If you see these doctors who did not become doctor and these doctors who actually went ahead and got a degree of medicine but made career in something else, ultimately everybody was seeking happiness, but then education got lost, the opportunity got lost. Maybe people did not get good kind of doctors sometime. So I hope you have understood that a career is much beyond your degree and education. If you feel so, yes, please type yes in the chat room. Let me see if whatever I have been talking so far, you have got it. Are we on the same platform? Are we on the sync?
Yes.
Yes. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you so much. So now let me ask you one simple question. My dear friends, when you think of career, when we think of our life, what should be the life? Do you want to impress people by your life, or do you want to impact the society by your life? Type life of impact if you want to lead a life of impact. And you may type impress if you want to lead a life of impress. A life which you want to impress, or life which you want to create an impact. Absolutely, absolutely. I love the clarity of thought, guys. At the age of 15 and 16, you guys are having wonderful clarity of thought. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. So, my dear friend, I think when somebody says that first earn and then make impact, my dear friend, you design your life of impact, money will come automatically to you. Don't worry. Earning is a part of life process, and it is not the objective. Those who have made it sole objective are leading a clueless life in this life. So design your life of impact, and earning will automatically follow. Definitely it will follow. We are not going to lead a life of impact without actually sufficing for ourselves, without making a living for ourselves, and without earning whatever we desire to earn. So absolutely, richest people in the world do have life of impact. It is not that only theoretical or philosophical people will have life of impact. And richness will come through your earning potential and earning activity through your career. So life of impact will take you, will carry you through all the hurdles which might come in your process. So if you want to lead a life of impact, my dear friends, you need to understand few basic fundamental, you need to have fundamental clarity. One, discover yourself. Now, when I say discover yourself, because many times I see that most of the children nowadays, and including parents, they have a misconception that people should do in career of their interest. And I'm sure in this group also, there might be many students who feel, nahi, mujhe jo interest hai, wahi main karunga. My dear friends, your statement is not the complete truth, because interest might fade away after 6 months. Interest might fade away after 2 years. Interest might fade away after 4 years. And I have gone through those examples wherein somebody was passionate about engineering in standard 12th. He said, "My engineering hi karunga. Mujhe engineering mein hi interest hai." In fact, mere paas architecture or interior designing ke bhi aise examples hai. In fact, across all faculties examples hai. But by the time, in fact, ek recent example hai, ek ladki jisne actually humanities mein jana chahiye tha. I had suggested her accordingly, but she said, "Nahi nahi, mujhe engineering mein jana hai." Actually, she didn't wanted to go. Her parents wanted her to do engineering. She went to engineering, and after second year, now she is absolutely disturbed, depressed, and she is saying that mujhe engineering acha nahi lag raha hai, mujhe aa nahi raha hai, I am unable to do. Mere backlog reh rahe hain. I have not passed all the subject in my third semester. So interest definitely plays a role, but only interest doesn't play or doesn't should not decide your career. So what is it that you should discover about yourself? You are seeing on the screen for past 5 minutes personality, aptitude, interest, emotional quotient, REAM. Of course, I'm going to talk about it, and orientation. Now you'll say, what is all this? How do you know all this? Yes, there are scientific processes to discuss. There are 16 factors in personality. There are 16 factors in everybody's personality. What is your prominent factor? There are more than nine different aptitudes or talents, you call them. That is your natural talent, what you are good at. Of course, then your interest is there. So interest cannot be undermined. And then, of course, is your emotional quotient. You ask your parents, you ask your teachers, that emotional stability or emotional quotient has been one of the biggest factor in the success of people right now, jo bhi corporate life mein hai ya personally business kar rahe hai, har jagah emotional quotient has played a major role in the success of people. The people who could not handle their emotions well did not succeed well. People who could not handle the emotions of their colleagues did not succeed well. So nowadays, in fact, many of the corporates have started taking a psychometric analysis test of employees for even only for emotional quotient. So my dear friends, you need to check out what is your emotional quotient before you decide on taking up a career path, because your success will depend quite considerably on all these factors, including emotional quotient. And then, of course, what is your dream? Most of you have mentioned that your dream should decide your degree. So what is your dream? I don't know how many of you are actually started dreaming or have a dream. Now, dream does not mean choosing a degree or choosing a profession. Your profession, your educational path is just a vehicle to your dream. It cannot be your dream. So what is your dream? Your talents and your skills should fuel your dream. Otherwise, your dream should be big enough to pull your talents and skills towards it. So do you have your dream? That is one of the important aspects. And then you should be understanding. So once you have discovered yourself, once you have had your dream, then you should understand the world of opportunities outside. How many of you feel that, yes, this is the right kind of process? Type yes in the chat room if you feel that, yes, this makes sense to you. Somewhere you are feeling, yes, this is making sense to you. Yes, yes, yes. Wonderful, wonderful. Yes, yes. So then comes your important task of identifying and understanding the world of opportunities. Now let's quickly understand the future world. Let's understand how to build a future-proof career. How many of you are ready for this? Say yes, say yes, say yes. You want to understand how to build a future career plan. Superb, superb, superb. Fantastic, fantastic. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. I love the energy of the room. So let's see, my dear friends. Right now, what is trending? UI designer, user interface designer, user experience designer, machine learning and artificial intelligence, ethical hacker, big data analyst, social media manager, drone operator, app developer. And let me tell you, some of the parents may not even know the names of these careers, because these careers did not exist 10 years ago. And 10 years is not a big time. In fact, some of these careers did not exist 5 years ago. So these are the trending careers of 2021. So why do we need future-proof careers? Well, the global environment is disruptive. There are so many disruptions happening around every moment. Right now, somewhere in the world, somebody is creating a disruption in a particular sector which has been there successfully stable for so many years. And overnight, they will be disrupting. Just look at whatever has happened in last few years in India. We had never experienced things like Uber. Humko malum nahi tha ki Uber and Ola jaisa koi cheez ho sakta hai market mein jo hamare traveling experience ko pura change kar de sakta hai. And can you imagine, neither Ola nor Uber own a single taxi of their own. And they are the largest taxi providers in the world. They are taxi service providers in the world. So that's how disruption is happening. App-based laundry applications are coming in. Nobody had imagined aisa kuch ho sakta hai. But now you have laundry applications, app-based laundry applications. There can be so many other examples. In fact, some of you might be knowing more than me. But career trends are changing, rise of smart machines and systems, and the most promising careers of today, let me tell you, didn't even exist a decade ago. And let me tell you, students, your friends or your siblings, I'm sure some of you might be having siblings who are in standard 5 and standard 6 right now. Those of your siblings will be making a career in the field which is not existent today. Aaj wo existence mein nahi hai field, aise field mein aapka bhai ya aapki behan career kar sakti hai. Possibly you might also do. Now that's the reason we need to have a career plan which is future proof. It shouldn't happen that by the time you are out of your college with certain degree, you suddenly see that that degree education has no scope at all left because some disruption came up and it entirely changed the landscape of that particular industry. Now let me tell you, those aspirants of medicine field who hate physics or chemistry or mathematics or electronics, they may need to rethink, because the doctors of future cannot keep themselves away from technology. In fact, they need to have a good understanding of technology which is coming out of mathematics and physics. They need to learn electronics. They need to learn how to operate machines, because most of the medical sector now is being bombarded heavily by electronic equipments, which are maybe you must have heard of robotic surgeries. There are so many surgeries happening nowadays with the help of machine. Now a doctor who is not convenient, not comfortable, not so good with operating gadgets or equipments, in spite of being a doctor, he will not get an employment if he doesn't cope up with the requirements of the market. So hatred for electronics cannot be your basis of going for medical. In fact, in future, most of the professions are going to need technology base. So your education has to be. So a few years ago, computer and IT was a different career. Nowadays, it is not a different career. Every career needs an IT orientation. Every career needs a person who is proficient with computers. So nowadays, computing and IT has become a backbone of almost every business. So you cannot say that I don't like computers or I don't like IT. You have to like, you will have to learn it whether you like it or not. So let me quickly tell you what are the new age careers. Ethical hacking, YouTubing, candid photography, image consultancy, are bahut sari career aise hai na, ye hamare aaj ke parents jo hai, I mean your parents might even feel are aisa koi career hota hai kya? We didn't even know this. Luxury brand management, app development, digital marketing, artificial intelligence, data analysis, and internet of things. Huge career opportunities in all these fields. These are right now trending careers, new age careers, and they are going to eat up with lot of old age careers. And what are the routes to admission? Entrance based examinations are there, merit based admissions are there, and of course profile based admissions are there. Let me tell you one more thing which is now emerging in India and globally. Of course it has been there for quite long. That is, you are not admitted to a college merely on the basis of your entrance exam or college study score. You are also admitted on the basis of your profile. What kind of personality have you developed by the age of 17 years? And typically they look at what you did in your 7th standard, 8th standard, 9th standard, 10th standard, 11th standard. What extracurricular activities did you do? What kind of personal development have you made? To what depth have you gone inside? Or you were that typical child who for the sake of hobby did multiple things and did not capture any one thing, did not master any one thing. Or they will look at it ki, yes, you earlier were interested in four things, but by standard 8th or 9th, you have picked up karate, or you have picked up debating, or you have picked up coding, or you have picked up dance, Kathak ho, Bharatnatyam ho, Bollywood ho, whatever you want. You have picked up that dance and you have dived deeper into it. You have achieved some level of proficiency into it. You have developed your personality. That's why they feel that you are the right kind of candidate for them. And many private universities have already started this process of admission. They ask, what is your statement of purpose? S-O-P. And students sometimes find it strange. What is that? Statement of purpose. फर्स्ट ईयर को एडमिशन लेने के लिए आजकल पूछा जा रहा है स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस, एंड यू कैनॉट राइट ए स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस ओवरनाइट. इट इज इजीली डिटेक्टेड. पीपल विल डिक्लाइन यू फॉर मेकिंग फेक क्लेम्स. सो योर स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस हैज टू बी सपोर्टेड बाय व्हाट यू हैव डन इन द प्रीवियस 3, 2, 3, 4 ईयर्स. सो दैट इज द एडमिशन रूट नाउडेज. सो दैट्स आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड दिस. यू हैव टू हैव ए स्ट्रॉन्ग प्रोफाइल. Whatever you do, it might be in Olympiads, it might be in quiz competition, it might be in academic certifications, it might be any leadership experience like MUN, and there are so many other platforms for your leadership experience. It might be youth exchange programs. Nowadays, a lot many students go for such kind of programs. It might be your participation in some social initiatives, and of course, your extracurricular activities. So that's how your profile has to be built before you actually go for careers. Now, traditional view on careers was, okay, there was science, then there was commerce, and then there was humanities. And we know how segregated everything was. And students of today really feel, yaar, aisa kaise ho sakta hai? Mujhe commerce mein jaake bhi arts ka subject padhna hai, toh kyun nahi padh sakta hoon main? Of course, now new education policy is coming, but it is not for you, unfortunately. So you will still have to struggle with this segregation in the market. But what is the new age segregation? Lekin, you cannot depend only on that art, science and commerce kind of thing. Now this is the new age specialization. Business and commerce ka specialization ho chuka hai. Government and administrative services ka alag specialization ho raha hai. Science and technology, STEM, alag specialization ho raha hai. Research and data, design and innovation, health and fitness, media and hospitality, social sciences, humanities and legal services. Now, you people, those who are in 11th and 12th today, you will be actually needing to define where do you want to work. And you cannot simply say that I will go to science and commerce and arts, which already you have chosen. So your next step is within commerce, where do you want to go? Within science, where do you want to go? Within arts, where do you want to go? And that is the journey which you need to take up in this fashion. Let's quickly see some of the careers which are trending careers and which are new age careers. So in the field of science and technology, you have merchant navy, engineering, aviation, computer application and architecture. And the new age careers which are coming up are ethical hacking and fashion technology. In the field of research and data, you have trending careers as physical sciences, mathematics and stats, actuarial science. Now this is something different which has been into existence for quite some time, but now it is definitely trending more because more and more we become data oriented. Actuarial sciences is actually becoming very, very important and it's highly rewarding career. Food and agriculture, life sciences, and the new age careers are environmental science and data mining. Now, data mining is something, the next big thing. In the field of design and innovation, again, of course, the trending careers are architecture, design, animation, graphics, UI design and UX design. And nowadays, these new things are coming up, design thinking and image consultant. You can become a design thinking consultant. You can become a design thinking trainer. Now, this is a very, very high demand job and it pays a lot as well. Then, of course, in healthcare and fitness, it's not no more only about becoming a MBBS or BAMS or BDS. There are multiple opportunities available in the healthcare sector, and healthcare sector is next big thing in the world. And you all have seen how entire world has struggled with this pandemic. How entire world has exposed himself or exposed itself in terms of their ability to create the necessary health infrastructure support for their citizens. So health sector is tremendously big, and these are some of the subsectors of the health: medicine, nutrition and dietetics, allied medicine, forensic science and genetics. And of course, the new age careers are bioinformatics. So information technology and medicine ka blending ho raha hai through bioinformatics. And of course, fitness expert is something coming up trendy. Nowadays, you see so many fitness experts and they are doing fantastically well. In spite of being now because of pandemic, they all have shifted online and people are really making good money and leading a life of impact because they are actually creating an impact in the lives of thousands of people just by becoming a fitness expert. So remember, you want to lead a life of impact, there are multiple opportunities for you to lead a life of impact. Of course, in social and then social science and humanities, you have trending careers as social service emerging very hugely across the globe. Law, of course, has been always there. Education and training, a big time, particularly in pandemic, online education has come up very, very aggressively, and archaeology. And then, of course, you have international relations and instructional design as the new age careers coming up. Media and hospitality, you have content writer. This is something much required career nowadays, much in demand career nowadays. Somebody who can write a content, be it for advertisement, be it for technology, be it for any kind of machine, be it kind for any kind of process, that is also called technical writing. So content writer, so those who have love for writing, they can write good. It may not be creative writing. Creative writing is different completely. But if you have a good penchant at language, you are good at writing and expressing something in linguistic manner, content writer can be a fantastic career for you, and it will pay you really good, and you will feel really good because you have got that kind of talent. Public relations, of course, is a good, those who like to interact with people, influence people, have a very extrovert kind of life, public relation is definitely a fantastic career. Filmmaking, of course, I need not explain this. Hotel management and journalism. And in the new age section in this particular faculty, you have event management coming up big time, and culinary arts. As usual, it has been always a good career for many people who have interest in culinary arts. And then, of course, public service domain, you have judiciary and administration, you have defense services, and you have civil services. And then in business and commerce, well, there are tremendous opportunities again. Entrepreneurship, operational and sales activities, marketing, finance and banking, commerce and accounting, distribution and logistics. And of course, in trend these days, social media marketing and sports management as well. So if you like sports, but you are not a sportsman, you can definitely get into sports management. So now the question is, if so many new career options are coming up, how do you take the track which is most suitable to you and build your career? So far, with this information, how many of you feel that yes, I mean, you have got good information and you are happy with the information you have received? Please type yes in the chat room. Wow, wow, thank you. We will be taking questions in some time. I think in next 2 to 3 minutes, we should be done with my part, and then we'll take up some questions. Yes, wonderful, wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I'm really happy that I could make some value addition to you today. Okay, so how do you actually define? So you identify your orientation style. There are 4 types of orientation styles: informative, information style, administrative style, creative style, and people style. Check out what is yours, and there are processes to check out this. Then your interest. There can be n number of interests, so you have to validate your interest. It's not just about your feeling or about your perception. Sometimes it is, or rather, it is necessary that you should scientifically validate your interest. So it's not about mera interest to mere ko malum hai. Validate, because you might have varied interest. Mujhe ye bhi malum, mujhe ye bhi karna hai, mujhe wo bhi karna hai. Sometimes you have multiple interests. So what is the degree of that interest? You need to check so that you can focus on the interest which is most prominently making you feel good. Then of course your personality. As I said, there are 16 factors to a personality. So where do you stand in those 16, all those 16 factors? And there is nothing good or bad about it. It's just suitability with various kinds of roles which you are going to lead in your life. So what is your personality? Understand your personality. Personality is not only about whether I look good, whether I am tall, whether I am fair, whether I am dark, or whether I like to talk to people or not, and whether I am disciplined or not. Okay, those are certain only very, very limited aspects of the personality. But many other detailed aspects of personality you need to check. Your parents will agree to this, ki kafi baar job mein aisa hota hai ki bande mein talent badhiya hai lekin personality uski suit nahi kar rahi hai us particular job profile ke liye. Sometimes it's like, okay, he needs to be emotionally stable, he needs to understand emotions of others, he needs to take decisions immediately. Bande mein talent hai us kaam ka, us domain ka, but personality is not suiting the job. Now this, you right now, you may not realize the importance of this, but let me tell you, the moment you land in your career, within first 6 months, you will realize your limitations in that career for that particular job profile. And then people keep on changing jobs just to feel happy. So your personality makes a lot of sense to you. So locus of control of your emotions, what is your resilience, what is your integrity, what is your moral conformity, what is your extraversion and agreeableness, what is your ability to do teamwork, what is your decision making capacity, how practical are you, what is your perseverance, what is your perfection orientation, what are your organizational skills, enthusiasm, how enterprising are you, and what is your intense pursuit? Where do you stand on all these matters as far as your personality goes will make a lot of impact on your career choice, will make a lot of impact on your success in your career. You check with your parents and you will realize this. And then, of course, your aptitude, your natural talents. There are various types of talents. You need to check out what is the degree of their proficiency or degree of their expertise in you. So it is always better to pick up a talent which is the most prominent talent in a personality and try to build a career on that domain. Otherwise, sometimes you get, because of any reason, there can be personality oriented reasons which make you choose a talent which is not so great in you. There might be some other bigger talent which you ignore. And then, of course, your emotional quotient. As I've already explained this aspect in detail, where do you stand in terms of emotions? So based on these, you can actually identify what are your 5 to 7 to 10 best fit career matches. Based on all those aspects, you can identify the best 5 careers which are most suitable for you. The careers, if you choose any one of them, you will be actually highly successful and highly happy as well. There are ways to do this. And a detailed comprehensive career report will help you. It will be actually your manual. It will be a reference manual for you so that you choose the right kind of life path for yourself. So there are multiple tools. When you start this journey, you can then explore various options available to you. So there are exhaustive career libraries available, not only with us, but also in the market wherein you can choose from. And you can actually define what can be your path with the help of a mentor. So my dear friends, based on all this, you should make your career roadmap, and then you should select your colleges and you should choose your entrance exams, map everything with your career plan, and go ahead with your actions. So my advice to you would be, discover yourself. Have a dream, take a mentor, very, very important. Most of the students nowadays don't realize the importance of a mentor. Ask your parents and they will say, ki yes, har bande ko life mein guru ki zarurat hai. So you may not have one person mentoring you for all the aspects. You can have multiple people, but for your career plan, do take a mentor who can look in front of you, who can look behind you, who can look sideways, who can have a bird's eye or view on you and tell you what to do and what can be good and what can be not so good for you. Make a plan for yourself. Choose your vehicle. Remember, your educational plan, your degree plan is just a vehicle. It is not your dream. Don't dream to become an engineer. Engineering is just one vehicle to achieve your dream. Don't dream to become a designer. Being a designer or taking up designing education is just a vehicle to achieve your ultimate dream. And once you have done all these four steps, first four steps, simply get into action. So this is a 5-point formula from my side for friends today. I am done with my speech or my guidance. I am sorry, I have exceeded my time with 5 minutes. Teacher, I apologize for that. But if you have any queries, you can shoot. Thank you so much. I hope you have liked this guidance. Those who have liked it, those who have enjoyed this, do go and type yes so that you give me motivation. And of course, those who have questions, you can shoot. Superb, 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 fantastic. You guys are liking it, you are loving it, you have said loved it, you have liked it, fantastic. Very informative guidance. Thank you. Thank you so much, Nidhi. Thank you so much, Ajinkya. Thank you so much, Jessica. Fantastic. I love you guys. Thank you so much. You liked it, you enjoyed this. Fantastic. Well, across marine engineering, if you ask me the pace will start usually depending on your skill, again, let me tell you, pay scales are not basis on, okay, you have done your marine engineering. It will be basis on what you know, what you have developed yourself, what you have learned practically for marine engineering. So, but to give you a broad idea, yes, the packages might start at 3-3.5 lakhs and they might go up to the upper limit. There is no upper limit. In fact, after a couple of years, you get huge salaries in marine engineering. Somebody wants to ask, can ask if typing is a challenge. Same with civil engineering. Again, as I said, civil engineering for long has been a very neglected or a very, not so glamorous kind of field, because every time hum log, mujhe yaad hai ki jab hum log engineering mein gaye the, tabhi yaar civil engineering, nahin, mechanical mein nahin mila, isliye civil engineering mein liya. But yes, good civil engineers are in high demand even today. So although you may not get good starting salary, but yes, if you prove yourself to be effective, you get into specializations like becoming a RCC consultant or becoming a particular, you take up a specialization in civil engineering in a particular thing, definitely you will earn fantastic amount of money. See, hotel management, yes, hospitality will be a career. This is a temporary phase. Pandemic is a temporary phase, my dear friend. Don't lose heart. Across the globe, still the hotel management will remain a fantastic career. It might get delayed currently because of this pandemic, but this is a global pandemic and we really can't do much about it. But hotel management always will remain a fantastic career. Don't worry. Sports career, yes, you need to have a good plan, because sports career, as a sportsman, it is short-lived. You might play for 8 to 10 years at the most, physically in the physical possibility, the range of physical fitness will define your range of your career. But people have now successfully demonstrated model of being a sportsman for a certain time and then shifting to either coaching or commentating or having a sports management company or starting a coaching academy. So you have all these Rahul Dravids of the world. You have Anil Kumble. You have Ravi Shastri from our times. You have Saurav Ganguly. You have Sachin Tendulkar, who have shifted to different careers once their sports career is over. So sports management, in fact, one of my students is currently doing a career in sports journalism. And let me tell you, he's just in the second year of his college and he is already a lead editor with Barca. So it's one of the largest publishing group in the field of football, sports, and he's editor even in the second year of his graduation. So sports is definitely a good option. MS Dhoni, yes, of course. There are, computer science mein bahut sare options hai. There are tremendous options. I think we will need to discuss one-on-one, because IT field is growing so that you might have, at least even in the current colleges, you at least have 10 to 12 different options. And then there are specialization courses. Nowadays, IT companies are not looking at mere computer science graduates. They are actually looking at what kind of different technologies have you learned. So there are various small courses, certifications, which actually keep you trendy and which you keep updated with the time. So computer science mein, there are, yes, tremendous opportunity, but depends on what you are going to focus on. Yes, blogging, content writing is blogging. So blogging is a fantastic career. Let me tell you, nowadays bloggers are earning good amount of money because professionals, companies are using their blogging skills to promote their product. So blogging is a fantastic career. Well, there is nothing called as what is better, IT or computer service engineering. That depends on what is your personality aligned to more. You might find the computer science better or you might find IT better depending on what you are. Let me tell you, no career is good or bad. If a particular career was bad, why would that have been? It would have been there in the first place itself. वो आता ही नहीं ना मार्केट में अगर करियर कोई बैड होता तो. सो नो करियर इज गुड और बैड, फ्रेंकली स्पीकिंग, इट्स हाउ यू मेक ऑफ इट, व्हाट यू मेक ऑफ इट. सो अंडरस्टैंड योर पर्सनालिटी व्हेन यू आर लुकिंग एट ए पर्टिकुलर करियर, व्हाट इज योर मैच विद दैट पर्टिकुलर करियर. सो फॉर दैट यू नीड टू गो इन टू एन इनवर्ड जर्नी फर्स्ट. बिफोर यू एक्चुअली थिंक ऑफ आउटवर्ड वर्ल्ड. ये जो मुझे सवाल आ रहे हैं कि ये फील्ड कैसा है, वो फील्ड कैसा है, वो फील्ड कैसा है, यस आई एम ट्राइंग टू गिव यू आंसर्स, बट वन आंसर फॉर एवरीबडी विल बी कि हैव यू डाइव्ड डीपर इनटू यू बिफोर यू हैव एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड टैपिंग आउटसाइड करियर्स. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, dive deeper into yourself. There are scientific processes for that. There are psychometric analysis, psychometric processes for you to understand all these aspects of your personality, so that then factually, objectively, you can actually know and figure out ki what is best for you. मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग को 50 साल पहले भी उतना ही फोकस था, उतना ही स्कोप था जितना आज है. सिविल इंजीनियर को उतना ही स्कोप था जितना आज है. सिमिलरली कंप्यूटर साइंस हो या आईटी हो, एवरीबडी विल हैव स्कोप. फॉर पीसीबी, एज आई सेड, देर आर एटलीस्ट 12 टू 15 डिफरेंट वेरियस फील्ड्स लाइक अलाइड साइंसेस, लाइक अलाइड मेडिसिन, लाइक फार्मेसी, लाइक health and fitness, nutrition and dietitians kind of thing. There are many more. There are pathology field mein there are multiple options available. So as far as information is concerned, let me tell you, there are more than 30,000 careers right now in the world. No career counselor will be able to tell you scope and nitty-gritties of each and every career. That is mere information. वो इन्फॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल एट द टिप ऑफ द योर फिंगरप्रिंट्स. गूगल करो कौन सा फील्ड का आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन चाहिए, विद इन अ मिनट यू विल गेट दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन. सो दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन, इफ यू जस्ट कीप ऑन गेटिंग मोर एंड मोर एंड मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन, इट विल फर्दर कंफ्यूज यू मोर. आपका दिमाग खराब कर देगा इन्फॉर्मेशन, इतनी इन्फॉर्मेशन मार्केट में अवेलेबल है. एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल एट द टिप ऑफ द फिंगर, एट द टिप ऑफ फिंगर टिप्स. पॉइंट इज, what information do you want, what information do you need, rather than want, I would say need. Understand that first, then figuring out that, say for example, once you have shortlisted your topmost five careers, then finding out information related to those five careers is much easier than sitting and just figuring out ki ye career ka information lo, wo career ka information lo. Why to then leave one career? You should take information of all the 30,000 careers, which is practically not possible, not necessary. It's absolutely crap. But if you figure out ki what are the best suitable careers for me, it might be one or two or three or sometimes five. Then finding out the various opportunities in those careers, the various possibilities of taking educational path in those careers, what are the colleges, what are the admission processes, what are the salaries which you get after that career, what are the various challenges thrown at that particular career, so that you will be facing those challenges when you enter that career. Iska study karna becomes easier, and that's where a mentor comes into play. He will guide you with the details of these particular things because he has already worked in those fields or he knows people who have worked in those fields. Now, वहां पे जो आप इंफॉर्मेशन लोगे, दैट विल बी मोर इंपैक्टफुल, दैट विल बी मोर नेसेसरी, एंड दैट विल क्रिएट अ डिफरेंस फॉर यू. अदरवाइज सीकिंग, ओके इस करियर में कितना स्कोप है, उस करियर में कितना स्कोप है, विल जस्ट कंफ्यूज यू. एम आई मेकिंग सेंस गाइज? प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड यस नो, वट एवर इट इज. आई वुड लाइक टू अंडरस्टैंड. या साधना जाधव सेज यस. ओके ओके, वंडरफुल वंडरफुल. So I think we are already overshoot by 15 minutes. If you have any more questions with respect to what I have been saying, you can shoot your questions to the mail ID which has been mentioned on the screen. You can call me, or you can in fact shoot your questions to your teachers, and they can send their all the consolidated questions to me, and I will be more than happy to make a small video for you guys, and which can be floated to you, your group.